TREC, that stands for Traversing European Coastlines, is an expedition and a project of a large scale that studies the organisms and ecosystems at the places where land and sea, the two major ecosystems, are meet across the entire European coastline.
I think what is very important with this expedition is that it's a completely unique opportunity to bring molecular biology to environmental sciences. So what molecular biology can do is to actually see who is there, how organisms are interacting, and what are the pollutants that are there in the ecosystem affecting life in the ecosystem. And as soon as you affect the smallest organisms, you are affecting the base of all the food chain. So everything that comes on top of that, so basically all life get affected, so everything is interconnected.
A mission for us to host TREC as a visitors, but also it's a very nice opportunity to participate to this exciting project, because many data will be produced, and we will have access to this data, so that's very important. And also it's an opportunity because there are many visitors from EMBL in Heidelberg, and so we will initiate collaboration with hopefully PhD students and postdoc and scientists.
The Tara Foundation is involved in the TREC project since the beginning, I think 3 years ago, because we're going to be the marine part of the survey they're going to do together with the TREC program. And we're going to sail along the lines and the coastlines of Europe to take samples, to study the ecosystem there and also the pollution along the coast of Europe.
Coastal regions, you have a chance to have an interaction between ecosystems, meaning how they interfere. And that goes along the lines how research is organized. There's many people working on the ocean, many people working on the soils, but together this hasn't been seen so far. And because as EMBL, we have a unique opportunity with our novel methods really to capture all this in an unprecedented scale.
So there are many different sampling activities going on. So what we will do in 120 sites covering almost all the European coast is we will be taking what we call a cross-sectional sampling from inland soil. So we take the upper part of the soil and we take it at different distances from the coast. And then you get soil that is non-affected by the sea and soil that is partially affected or more affected by the sea.
So yeah, today we are sampling the first spot for terrestrial samples. So we have 4 points on the land, the sediment, the water, and then Tara, the boat that is sampling further away in the ocean.
And then we will also be collecting plankton. So the Tara OceanS Foundation and the Tara OceanS Consortium have this boat that they have been using for 15 years for expeditions, and they are experts in getting plankton and doing many different kind of sampling processing with them.
So what's really new with this expedition is that we will be sampling on the boat, and within a few minutes or hours, we can actually look at the sample that we have been taking from the ocean right away, thanks to the mobile labs that will be following Tara on land.
From a scientific perspective, we expect some breakthroughs, obviously, but we are pretty sure with the setup, take chemical pollution, for example, you know, what kind of cells, what kind of animal react, which ones not, and why.
For us, we are focusing on planktons, and what we essentially do is we go out on the seas and collect them straight from the waters.
So back in the lab, we do some more filtrations, again, to clean up the sample a little more. Then we concentrate it to a smaller volume. And when we're happy with the samples, then we're actually proceeding to the next step, which is fixation in our case.
Planktons are a diverse group of protists. There are thousands and thousands of species that still haven't been studied. We don't understand their impact on the ecosystem and how they can be beneficial or harmful to the ecosystem. And that's the idea with TREC, that we want to sort of make this link between the ultrastructure of organisms with ecology.
We're going to start to understand about the microbes that are actually being transported from the air to the sea or vice versa. Along with these microbes, are genes which can be potentially hazardous to both environments.
But for me, the real question is how biodiversity evolves in so many conditions. So it's about climate, it's about geology, it's about geomorphology, about landscape, and also about human pressure, so anthropic pressure on the natural systems.
We are looking at different coastal environments. So you're not just looking at pristine coastlines, you're looking at urban areas, which are developed cities and ports. And we're also looking at agricultural land, for instance.
On a European level, we are extremely lucky because as EMBL we are very well placed to be doing this expedition, and on a public engagement level it means that we are really well connected to all of these local partners. So that's how we try to build these bridges locally, is we talk to our local partners, we try to understand through them which of the activities that we have developed would work well, maybe we need to adapt them a bit, and we go very much through them to reach our local audiences. We also do that by doing everything in the local language, so this is a really huge point to connect to local audiences.
So in the TREC context, in this visit context, we are also going to develop together all kind of events for raising awareness of the public toward the ocean, what we call ocean literacy actually, so that they know better the ocean.
And then of course we engage with schools. With the schools we engage on several levels, so at some of the stops we will go to schools or we invite the schools to come to the marine station, and we do the same as, so Nexus Island, the workshop with the public, we do that with the schools too.
I think TREC goes far beyond. It's an engagement of the EMBL member states. So we go out, we bring outreach to the public in many ways. So either locally via our public engagement activities, we hope also via the media, having basically an idea on how important this kind of environmental research is. So up to the politicians in a way. So there are many things beyond. On a way, we also will train scientists on the new technologies that EMBL will provide. So it goes in all kinds of different layers beyond the scientific ones.
The Tara Foundation is collaborating with EMBL very closely since 3 years now to prepare this program, to make sure that this is possible, this is funded, to make sure that we are ambitious also about what we're going to do together. And it's amazing to have a boat sailing along the coastline and trucks on land driving together to understand the gradients of the coastlines, which is never done before. So that's great, and I think it's going to be an amazing journey.